You all right?
Nathan!
In January for deaf children called DAR, which centres around life in a deaf theatre, where you can have a look at how deaf theatre productions are put together. Ray Harrison Graham will be the presenter, and it begins on Channel 4 from January. And talking about what's on Channel 4, William G. Stewart will be proceeding over another edition of the quiz show, 15 to 1 at 4:30. But Glenn Kinsey is standing by at Central Television Studios in Birmingham with another rendition of Children's ITV just after his birthday yesterday. So happy birthday to Glenn. By the way, and in the meantime, we'll play you some festive music. We'll be right back.
This Christmas on Thames, open up Cosgrove Hall's Box of Crackers, a festive season of their award-winning animated films. You'll meet the Fool of the World and join his incredible adventures on a flying ship. There's Robert Browning's classic poem, The Pied Piper of Hamelin. And don't forget him.
The BFG! That's me!
You'll meet him at 10:30 this Christmas Day.
How are you today? Wednesday, just a week till Christmas Day. I'm dead excited, and I'm actually very full up for my birthday cake yesterday. What a surprise that was. That cake they brought in, we're all full up, actually. Just about finished the cake off. Thank you to my sister Suzanne for that cake. What have we got for you today on Children's ITV? Well, we've got Grot Bags in Hound of the Basket Cases, which is the last in the series, and not the fake Ghostbusters, the real Ghostbusters in Christmas Marks a Spot. That's coming up later on. Sylvester's ready for that as well. Now it is time for Grot Bags in the Hound. The Hound of the Basket Cases. Let's have a look.
Yes, it's me, Grot Bags. I'm back, rats.
Where's the cans of fizzy pop?
They're in the cool bag.
Oh, cool, man.
Where's the cheese sandwiches?
They're there, right in front of you.
Oh, those are the cheese sandwiches, are they? I had them down as Frisbees on my radar.
Well, let's just be grateful that little mistake's been sorted out before you chucked the sarnies all over the field and tried to wolf down a Frisbee.
I love picnics!
Yeah, well, unless the ladies stir themselves, it'll be dark before we get there and we won't be able to see what we're eating anyway.
Well, I could keep everyone informed using my radar.
All right. I give up. Butter the Frisbees now.
Oh, dear, what a blow.
Has your mascara run, Doris?
Well, I would. Acne to that face.
The picnic's off.
What? Why?
It's something I heard on my radio.
Oh, you mustn't pay any attention to the weather forecast.
It wasn't the weather forecast, Norman. It was a warning. They said there's something on the loose, on the moor.
What? A runaway chicken? No problem.
It's bigger than that.
A runaway turkey.
They don't know. They said they've only heard it howling.
Could have been a squirrel that stubbed its toe.
A monstrous howl. They said came from a gigantic animal.
Here, what was Grot Bags doing last night?
Norman, I think you failed to appreciate the seriousness of the situation. Out there, on the moor, under our very windows, lurks a huge monster that howls like a grizzly bear with acid indigestion.
Great! Sign him up! We could sell a million records.
Right! I'm armed! Just let them midges start again this year.
There's a problem that's graver than midges, madam.
Oh, I've thought of that, Doris. I've got two pairs of bloomers on, so the red ant menace will be neutralised with a sensible defence policy.
I think you're underestimating the capability of the foe.
If it's wasp, it's war. I'll burn them out.
Grotty, most people go on a picnic to relax. You go to refight World War II with the Insect Kingdom.
But we can't go on a picnic.
Did you listen to your radio this morning?
Yes.
What did you hear?
Nothing.
Did you remember to turn it on?
No!
Then I must be the bearer of bad news. There's a huge howling monster out on the moor.
Don't be so